recession, depression, and unemployment. This song's for you.
Today's a new day, but there is no sunshine. Nothing but clouds, and it's dark in my heart, and it feels like a cold night. Today's a new day, but where are my blue skies? Where is the love and the joy that you promised me? Tell me it's alright.
I'll be honest with you,
I almost gave up, but a power that I can't explain fell from heaven like a shower. Now
when I think how much better I'm gonna be when this is over,
I smile. Even though I hurt, see, I smile.
You do.
I smile.
Come on and
smile. It's so hard to look up when you've been down. Sure would hate to see you give up now.
God's people,
you look so much better when you smile. So smile.
Now every day ain't gonna be perfect, but it still don't mean today don't have purpose.
Truly I will bless the Lord at all times, and his praises shall continually be in my mouth. My soul, Mount Calvary, shall make her boast in the Lord, and the humble shall hear thereof and be glad. Oh, magnify the Lord with me, and let us exalt his name together. For truly our God, he is worthy, he is worthy, he is worthy to be praised. Come on, put your hands together wherever you are on this Sunday morning, amen, and give God some glory and a hand clap of praise, for he is worthy to be praised. Hallelujah. Giving thanks and praises to our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. This is Pastor Ricky Dixon, pastor of the Mount Calvary Missionary Baptist Church in Sun River Terrace, Illinois. And again, I want to welcome you to our Sunday morning sermon. Amen. I thank God for every one of you who are viewing this video. Amen. And I pray, amen, that God will visit us all afresh as he ministers to all of us today through his holy word. Amen. Before I get started, amen, you all know I cannot sing, but there's always a song in my spirit, and the one that's really been stirring in my spirit is the one, I believe it's by Walter Hawkins and the Love Community Choir, but I know it was Walter Hawkins, an old song, you know, tragedies are commonplace, all kind of diseases, you know, people are slipping away, economy's down, people can't get enough pay, but as for me, all I can say is, thank you, Lord, for all you've done for me. Amen. And then it goes on, the chorus says, it could have been me, outdoors with no food. Amen. With no clothes. Amen. Just another number. But the song, the essence of the song is we ought to be able to thank the Lord for all that he's done for us. Amen. And I wonder if there's anybody out there this morning besides me, amen, that can say with me, thank you, Lord, for all you've done for me. It could have been me. It should have been me. And it would have been me if it had not been for the Lord that was on our side. Amen. But again, we have much to be grateful for. Amen. And again, just want to say hallelujah. Thank you, Lord, for all that you've done for me. Amen. The question has been asked, is there a word from the Lord? I believe there is a word from the Lord. Those that have your Bibles, turn with me to the 27th division of Psalm. Psalm 27, and we're going to look at one verse this morning, verse number 13. Amen. Psalm 27 and 13. And I'm going to read from the King James Version. Amen. And you can follow along with me. Amen. The text says this, I had fainted unless I had believed to see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. Amen. I had fainted unless I had believed to see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. Amen. The grass withereth and the flower fadeth, but the word of our Lord shall stand forever. Amen. Church, I want to speak to you this morning from this subject. Amen. I want to talk to you about the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. Amen. Amen. And church, as I start out, if you don't remember anything from this sermon this morning, remember this, God is good. Amen. Because of all the negativity out there, I know that it's easy to overlook and forget about how good God is. But in spite of all that we see on the news, amen, and in spite of all that's going on around us, church, I need to tell you this morning that God is good. Amen. He's still good. Amen. And I told you last week that even on our bad days, God is still good. And my brothers and sisters, can you really imagine how bad and how awful things would really be right now if God wasn't good? Think about it. How bad and tragic and awful things would be right now if God was not good. So I thank God this morning, amen, sharing with you and reminding us of his goodness through his son, David, a man that he said was after his own heart. Amen. So David is the writer of this entire 27th Psalm. And there are different schools of thoughts out there with different theologians and Bible scholars about, you know, what was going on in David's life when he penned these words in verse number 13. Some think he penned it when he was on the run from King Saul. Others believe he penned it as he was in his old age and he was reflecting back, amen, on how God had delivered him from the giant with the sword through Abishai at that time. But, you know, regardless of when he wrote it and regardless of what he was going through when he wrote it, we all know that David is the writer of this psalm. Amen. Amen. Now, as we look at this one verse, my brothers and sisters, notice now. Notice, David did not say that he was going to see the land of the living, but he said he was going to see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. Amen. And when David said the land of the living, again, not to get too deep, but David, when he said in the land of the living, some believe he was referring to Jerusalem. Amen. To the holy city. Amen. Where all the holy oracles of God were residing. Amen. Whereas some others believe that he was referring to heaven. Amen. Which is truly, as we know, the land of the living. Because in heaven, there will be no more death, no more dying, no more weeping, no more tears. Amen. No more death. Amen. I wish I had some Bible readers here who understand what God has said about heaven in the book of Revelation. But church, there is nothing, though, talking about heaven. Now, there is nothing like having the hope of eternal glory and the hope of spending all of eternity, amen, and the future glory and all the pleasantness, amen, that we read about and that we can't even imagine, amen, but having all of that deep down in our hearts, amen, when we have that, my brothers and sisters, that can help keep us from fainting, amen, under all of the troubles of this present world, amen. But let me remind you of something this morning, that we don't have to wait till we get to heaven. We can see the goodness of the Lord manifesting itself right now in the day and time in which we are living. Amen. Don't forget, church, I told you all a few weeks ago that the promise of God is that we would see and reap a hundredfold in this lifetime, not in the world to come, but in this lifetime. An amen goes right there. Amen. Hallelujah. Now, getting back to Psalm 27:13. Here, my brothers and sisters, is what David is saying in this one verse. He's saying this. He's saying, if he didn't believe he was going to see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living, that he would have fainted, church, underneath all of the weight and underneath all of the pressure that was on him and on his shoulders. Amen. And church, at some point in our journey, at some point in our Christian walk, amen, all of God's children are subject to become faint when our troubles become many and when our burdens become overwhelming. We all are tempted, amen, and we will all become subject to becoming faint, amen, because the reality is we're living in a fallen world. The enemy is after us, amen. Thank God he can't get to us, but it doesn't stop him from being after us. Amen. And if it had not been for the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living, all of the turmoil and the troubles and the problems and the weights that are on our shoulders would make us faint. Amen. They would become overwhelming. Amen. But the reality is God is a keeper. God is a sustainer. Amen. And even though all of that is true, that we're living in troubled times and burdens and pressure is on our shoulders, it's true. But you and I can still, my brothers and sisters, be encouraged by the fact that troubles, heartaches, and pains one day will soon be over. Hallelujah. We can be encouraged, church, by the fact that trouble don't last always. And we can be encouraged by the fact that the God we serve, he'll get in the fire with us just like he did with the three Hebrew boys. Wish I had a witness. Amen. We can be encouraged by the fact that his rod and his staff would comfort us. Amen. Just like this same David wrote over in the 23rd Psalm. And church, we can be encouraged by the fact that all of our burdens, we can take them to the Lord in prayer. And just like the choir sings, ain't that good news? Oh, yes, it is. That is good news. Now, church, now, my brothers and sisters, the belief now that kept David from fainting was his belief that he would see the goodness of the Lord with his own eyes. Amen. Not that he would hear about the goodness of the Lord towards somebody else, but the belief that kept sustaining David and the belief that kept David from fainting was the belief that he would see the goodness of the Lord for himself. And church, that's the same belief that can keep you and I from fainting during these turbulent and troublesome times. Amen. We need to believe with all of our heart that in spite of disease and pestilence being in the land, in spite of sheltering in place, and in spite of the need to maintain social distancing, that we are still going to see the goodness of the Lord. As a matter of fact, I would challenge you, and I would even say this, amen, I would argue that we're seeing the goodness of the Lord right now. Amen. Come on now. Jeremiah said it this way over in Lamentations chapter 3, somewhere around that 22nd and 23rd verse. He says, "This I recall to my mind, therefore have I hope. It is of the Lord's mercies that we are not consumed because his compassions fail not. They are new every morning, church. Great is thy faithfulness." Amen. Again, I would argue that we are seeing the goodness of the Lord right now. Amen. Let me go a little deeper. Amen. Every morning that we're on the wake-up list, we're seeing the goodness of the Lord. Every time we can go out to the grocery store, to the pharmacy, amen, and God keeps us and we come back home safe and sound and healthy, amen, we are seeing the goodness of the Lord. Whenever you and your family are not showing signs and symptoms of having coronavirus, amen, we are seeing the goodness of the Lord. Every time we can go to the refrigerator, amen, and get something to eat, we are seeing the goodness of the Lord. Every time we lay down at night and we got a roof over our head, amen, and we are seeing the goodness of the Lord. Church, I'm trying to tell you this Sunday morning, amen, that we are seeing the goodness of the Lord in the right here and in the right now, amen. We're seeing the goodness of the Lord all day long and every day long, amen. So why don't you just take a second or two to give God some praise this morning for his goodness and to thank him right now, amen, for his mercy and his loving kindness towards every one of us, because he's allowing us to experience and see and partake and to embrace the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living, in the here and now, amen. Not in the by and by, but in the here and now. That's something to shout about, amen. Church, as we move on, what kept David strong now in the midst of his crisis was that he believed, listen to this now, he believed in all of his heart that he was going to outlive his troubles. Boy, that's saying something right there. Amen. And church, David believed he was going to outlive all of his troubles. And that's the mindset, my brothers and sisters, that you and I have got to have. We've got to believe we are going to outlive all of our troubles, and we're going to proclaim that they are not going to get the best of us, and we've got to speak it that they are not going to take us out. Amen. Church, if you can believe like David that you're going to outlive your troubles, then it won't be no room in your mind for mental illness. Amen. I know this is Mental Health and Awareness Month, and I know many people are struggling with mental illness and depression from having to be sheltering in place and not able to do what they used to do. But if you and I really believe like David that we're going to outlive our troubles, that we're going to outlive this virus, that we're going to outlive all of this quarantining and all of that, amen, won't be no room in our mind for mental illness. If we believe it like David, amen, that we're going to outlive all of our troubles, amen, you won't be depressed, won't be no room for depression, amen. And why? Because we will have joy deep down in our heart, knowing that all of this is going to come to pass and that we're going to outlive all of our troubles. Amen. We're going to have joy, again, I say, deep down in our souls. And this joy that I have, this joy that you have, the world didn't give it, and the world can't take it away. So come on, church, encourage yourself this morning. Speak over yourself this morning, amen, and declare, amen, over you and your house, amen, that we gonna outlive our problems. Hallelujah. Speak those things that be not as though they already were. Decree it and declare it this morning. Speak over yourself. Speak over your house. Speak over your children. Speak over your family. Speak over your community. Speak over your church and say, we are going to outlive every one of our problems. And if you can believe it in your heart and confess it with your mouth, God says, I will bring it to pass. Hallelujah. Amen. Now, even in all of that, I know that there are still some amongst us. I know that there are still some that are saying within themselves, you know, God, I believe in your goodness, amen. But Lord, how much longer, Lord? How much longer, God? How much longer do we have to shelter in place? And how much longer do we need to wear masks and social distance? And Lord, when will this storm be over? Amen. Lord, when is this pandemic going to be over? Lord, how much longer? And church, let me say this to you. It's okay to ask questions of God. Job did it, amen. And God encourages us whenever we are despondent, whenever we are unsure, whenever we are uncertain, whenever we have a question, amen, that we need answered. God said, bring it to me, and I'll be able to answer every question that you have, amen. So it's okay to ask questions. But church, even in asking, God needs you to know this, amen. He is still with you, amen. He still got his hands on you, amen. In spite of the uncertainty, in spite of all the questions of how much longer, Lord, God said, I'm still with you. I still got my hand on you. I'm still keeping you. I'm still covering you. I'm still sheltering you. So you'll be able to withstand whatever it is that you're going through, however how long I'll allow it or authorize it to be in your life. Because I'm still with you, because I still got my hand on you, you can make it. You can keep coming out of this, amen. God says you can make it, amen. So in spite of all that you're going through this morning, remember this, because of the goodness of the Lord, God has promised no weapon that is formed against us shall prosper, amen. And church, coronavirus ain't nothing but a weapon, amen. Not having, you know, your normal lives ain't nothing but a weapon, amen. The enemy constantly coming up telling you he gonna kill you and he gonna destroy you and he gonna take you out and coronavirus is gonna get you and all this, that, and that. They are nothing more than weapons, amen. And the promises of God are yea and amen. And God promised us that no weapon formed against us shall prosper. And that, my brothers and sisters, is some more shouting stuff. Amen. So church, maybe, just maybe this morning, you and I can stand to learn something from David. Amen. In the midst of all that David was going through, he took some time to think about the goodness of the Lord that God has shown him in times past. Amen. And maybe, church, instead of murmuring and complaining and pouting because you can't get out, because you can't get your nails and your feet done and your hair done like you used to, because, brothers, you can't get that haircut, get that fade or whatever like you used to, amen. Maybe we ought to think about what he's already done. Amen. And maybe we ought to think about, like David, how good God has already been. Amen. Pastor Dixon, what are you really saying? Church, here's what I'm really saying. Some of our children, think about these things now. Some of our children used to pout and complain and didn't want to wake up in the morning to go to school. But now they don't even have to go to school at all. Amen. They can stay at home and sleep in because they got e-learning. Now, church, that's the goodness of the Lord. Amen. Some of us, amen, just telling the truth on ourselves, amen. Some of us used to murmur and complain about our jobs, amen. But in the midst of the highest unemployment rates that this country has ever seen, we still got one, amen. I'm telling you, that's the goodness of the Lord, amen. Some of us used to murmur and complain about not only about our job, but having to commute, amen, and go into the office. But now we don't have to because we can work from home. And again, that's the goodness of the Lord. Some of us used to talk about how tired we were and how we wish we could get some more rest. Amen. Well, now we can get all the rest we want because ain't nothing open and we can't go nowhere. So that, my brothers and sisters, is the goodness of the Lord. Come on, I'm going to keep going now. Some of us used to say how we wish we had more time to spend with God and studying His Word and praying and meditating and talking to Him and growing and maturing in the faith and developing. Well, now you ain't got nothing but time on your hands. Amen. That, church, is the goodness of the Lord. Some of us, amen, used to wish, your life wasn't so busy that you could spend some time with your kids, teaching them some life skills that you know they're going to need when they go off to college to be all by themselves and living and by themselves or for the first time in their lives. Amen. Well, now you got all the time that you need to show them how to wash their own clothes, fold their own clothes, cook their own food, clean up behind themselves. Amen. Like you and I do. Amen. That, church, is the goodness of the Lord. Some people complain about not being able to go to the mall and shop like they used to, but you still got money in your pocket and in the bank, and you can still go online and shop, and now you can get free delivery. Come on here, amen. That is the goodness of the Lord, amen. Some people right now complaining about not being able to go to the movies and watch a movie and all this, that, and that. Can't go to the theater like you used to, amen. But don't forget this. You got cable TV, amen. You got Netflix, you got Hulu, you got Roku, you got Fire Sticks that's been broken. You got all of that, and now you don't even have to pay to go to the show, amen. You can save some money now. That, church, is the goodness of the Lord. You've been able to, come on now, think about this. You've been able to ride for 3 weeks or more off of a full tank of gas, and you ain't never been able to do that in times past. Amen. That, church, is the goodness of the Lord. Amen. You've been praying and asking God to help you build up your savings account. Amen. And God has allowed some of us and have touched some of our creditors. Amen. Who've now allowed us to skip some payments and put some things on the back end, and now you're finally able to save a dollar or two and create and build up a savings account. That, church, is the goodness of the Lord. Amen. Oh, some of us, come on now, think about it. Some of us got a reason to thank God for COVID-19. Some of us got a reason to thank God for coronavirus and for sheltering in place. God is working behind the scenes in this pandemic. God is blessing in the midst of it all. God is restoring. God is repairing. God is opening some doors. God is making a way. And if I was in the sanctuary of the mighty Mount Calvary Missionary Baptist Church right now, because I feel this thing, I would shout out, ain't he all right? Ain't he all right? Ain't the Lord good? And then some people in the back would holler back, yes, amen. And I would go on and say, if you believe it, shout yes. And some people would shout yes. And that would make me go, and they would go. And next thing we know, our hands are up in the air. Next thing we know, our mouths are open. And we're thanking God for the goodness of the Lord. So we might not be in Mount Calvary right now. We might be in our living room or our family room or in our bedroom or wherever we are. But we can still open up our mouths like we was at the church. We can still lift up our hands like we was at the church. We can still say, thank you, Jesus, like we was at the church. Amen. We can still thank and praise God for the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. And like David said, I almost fainted had I not seen and believed of the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. Church, believe it. Amen. And you shall receive it. Amen. If you can believe it, God says this morning, you can receive it. Amen. Don't think of the negativity. Don't dwell on all the bad stuff you hear on the news. Come on, let's worship God and thank God this morning for being able to see and be partakers and recipients of the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. God is good, amen. God is great, and God is greatly to be praised. I know he's good because you're watching me and I'm watching you, amen. I know he's good because we're still on the wake-up list. I know he's good because he's still providing and making a way. I know he's good because the lights are still on. The internet bill has been paid. I know God has been good, amen. So in spite of all that's going on around us, all the negativity and all the complaining, amen, all the death tolls and the positive test tolls, God is still good, and God is still in the land of the blessing, and we are in the land of the living. So we got much to be grateful for. So let's focus on the goodness of the Lord and not on our problems. And just like David, we can then say without a shadow of a doubt, I believe that I'm going to outlive my problems and that something good is going to come out of this. Church, may the Lord God bless you real, real good is my prayer. And I pray and hope that this word has encouraged you in some way, shape, fashion, or form on this morning. Amen. We got so much to be thankful for, and we got so much to give God glory for his goodness. So come on, just put your hands together. Amen. And thank God for the goodness of the Lord that he shows to you and that he shows to me in the land of the living. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. There may be somebody viewing this video today that has never confessed Jesus as Lord and Savior of your life. I want to encourage you right now and let you know that God is in the saving business, and he can save your soul and write your name in the Lamb's Book of Life right now. So if you're out there and you know that you've never received Jesus and you're not sure that if you died right now, if you would go to heaven or hell, if you're unsure, why don't you pray this prayer with me? Heavenly Father, I come asking that you will forgive me of my sins. Lord, I ask that you will receive me into your kingdom, and I pray that you will strengthen me and help me to live for you all the rest of the days of my life. I believe that Jesus is the Son of the living God. I believe that he died for my sins and got up on the third day with all power in his hand. And Lord, I want to live for you the rest of my life. Amen. Church, if you prayed that simple prayer, my brother and or my sister, I again want to be one of the first to welcome you to the body of Christ and to tell you that now you have new life. Old things have passed away. Behold, all things have now become new. And again, welcome, welcome, welcome to the family of God and to the body of Christ. Get into a great Bible teaching and believing church. And I know you can't go join anywhere right now because unfortunately the church doors are closed. But Mount Calvary and others are still reaching the masses, amen, with the mercy of the master, amen, ministering to the master through Facebook and through conference calls. So if you need to follow with us on Wednesdays at 7 and on Sundays at 11 a.m., amen. And every night we're still praying and believing God and touching and agreeing on our prayer conference call Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. That information is out on our church Facebook page. So my prayer and my hope is that all of you will dial in and let's touch and agree night after night and believe God and have a little talk with Jesus, believing it will and he will make everything all right. On Thursday nights, don't forget, we are not praying on the Mount Calvary Missionary Baptist Church prayer conference call, but rather we're going and joining with the Kankakee Baptist District Association at 6 o'clock on Thursday evenings. Amen. Dialing into that number and to that Zoom prayer conference call. So all of that information to my brothers and sisters is out on our church Facebook page. So God bless you. God keep you. As we get ready to close out, let's remember everyone on our prayer list. Pray for all the bereaved families, the Locketts, the Lasters, amen, the Wills and the Lightfoots. And pray for Sister Henry and her family on the transition of her mother. Pray for all of those first responders and all the heroes, amen, that are out there in the medical field and serving others, amen. And pray for all the, what I call the heroes that are working in the stores and in the warehouses, driving trucks to get food and the necessities that we need to make it, amen. They are our heroes. Pray for those working in the nursing homes and those working in the prisons and all of that. Pray for our families and our relatives that are in nursing homes and incarcerated. Pray that God will keep them during these times. All I'm trying to say is we've got to pray without ceasing, and we've got to pray ye one for another. Amen. Again, church, I need you and you need me and we need God. Amen. But in the goodness of the Lord, in the land of the living, I believe it will manifest itself and we will see it. Amen. So until we meet again tonight at the 6 o'clock hour, amen. My hope and my prayer is that the Lord our God will keep and bless every one of you real, real good. Amen. So, amen. Everybody, give me my big old Holy Ghost hug first. Amen. God bless you. I feel you all.
Nothing but clouds and it's dark in my heart and it feels like a cold night. Today's a new day. But where are my blue skies? Where is the love and the joy that you promised me? Tell me it's alright.
I'll be honest with you.
I almost gave up, but a power that I can't explain fell from heaven like a shower.
When I think how much better I'm gonna be when this is over,
I smile, even though I hurt, see.
you do.
I'll smile.
Come on and
smile. It's so hard to look up when you've been down. Sure would hate to see you give up now.
God's people.
You look so much better when you smile.